Okay, students, let's learn English again. Now, still in past tense. Sekarang masih past tense, but past tense here is different with the last meeting, beda dengan pertemuan sebelumnya. Past tense here is the verbal sentence. Verbal sentence in past tense. What is the difference here? Apa bedanya di sini? Verbal sentence here, a sentence is the predicate using verb. What is verb? Verb is kata kerja. Jadi, verbal sentence ini kalimat yang menggunakan kata kerja. Beda dengan kalimat sebelumnya yang menggunakan predikat to be. Nah, the formula here is for positive sentence, subject plus verb 2 and object. Look at this. If the verb 1 study, verb 2 is studied. Study and studied has the same meaning, yaitu mempunyai arti yang sama, yaitu berbeda. If verb 1 is study, verb 2 is studied. Study and studied have the same meaning, mempunyai arti yang sama, yaitu belajar. But for positive sentence here, cause this sentence is past tense, you have to use verb 2 here. Verb 2 from verb 1. Study can be studied. Speak can be spoke. Swim can be swam. Eat can be ate. And drink can be drank. Here, verb 1 and verb 2 have the same meaning. Study, belajar, berbicara, berenang, makan, dan minum. Kedua-duanya memiliki arti yang sama, meskipun cara menulisnya berbeda. Jadi, kalimat past tense di sini fokus pada verb 2. Fokus to verb 2. Okay, for positive 1, subject, verb 2, and object. Andi as subject. Study, verb 2 is studied. Why? Kenapa study, belajarnya harus menggunakan studied? Ya, karena di sini kalimatnya lampau atau sudah berlalu. And the object is English. So, Andi studied English. The meaning of the sentence of this sentence, Andi sudah belajar bahasa Inggris, atau Andi dulu belajar bahasa Inggris. Jadi sekarang Andi tidak belajar lagi. It's for positive sentence. Next, we try to use the word speaks. Andi speak the subject is Andi. The predicate is speak or spoke, and the object is object. So the right choose which one is the right, speak or spoke. Yang benar menggunakan kata speak atau spoke. Yeah, the right word here is spoke. So Andi spoke English, not Andi speak English. Jadi bukan Andi speak English, yang benar adalah Andi spoke English. Okay, the next sentence is negative sentence. The formula here is subject, predicate-nya, the predicate here is using did not and verb 1. Did not plus verb 1 and object. Why here to be verb 1? Kenapa di sini menjadi verb 1? Because did here is verb 2. Verb 1 from did is do. Do, did, artinya melakukan. So, did here is verb 2. If this sentence there is did, the verb must be verb 1, not verb 2 again. Jadi kalau subjeknya sudah ada kata did atau did not, verbnya kembali ke verb 1. So it's differences between positive and negative. Perbedaannya dengan kalimat positif, kalau kalimat positif langsung verb 2, sedangkan kalimat negatif sudah ada did, jadi verbnya kembali ke verb 1 atau kata kerja bentuk 1. The example is Andy as a subject. The predicate is did not speak. Speak here is verb 1. And the object is English. Okay, student, next, let's practice negative sentence. Here I have a sentence: they did not eat or add a bowl of noodle. They as a subject, did not here, just like the formula, and you can choose between eat or add. A bowl of noodle as an object. So you have to choose eat or add. The formula here: subject, did not, verb 1, and object. Subject is right, did not is right. Eat and add, you have to choose one of them. Okay, what is the right? Yeah, the right is using eat. Why you have to use it? Because the negative sentence here, you have to use verb 1. The verb 1 of it here is eat, not add. Add here as verb 2, but eat as verb 1. Jadi kalimat ini yang benar harus menggunakan kata eat, bukan add, karena eat di sini adalah kata kerja bentuk 1 sesuai dengan rumusnya, yaitu verb 1. Jangan menggunakan add, karena add di sini verb 2. The next sentence is interrogative sentence. The formula is did, subject, verb 1. Remember that here you have to use verb 1. After this, object. Did, subject, verb 1, and object. Did, at the first time, you as a subject, drink and drunk, you have to choose one of here. Kamu harus pilih salah satu dari drink dengan drink. A cup of coffee is as a object. Look at this table. There is drink and drank. You have to remember that here, you have to use verb 1. Kamu harus menggunakan verb 1. So, which one will you choose? Drink or drink? Yeah, the right sentence is you have to use drink. So, drink here is wrong. So, how the sentence? Bagaimana kalimatnya? Did you drink a cup of coffee? Not. Did you drink a cup of coffee? Yang benar adalah did you drink a cup of coffee? Bukan did you drink a cup of coffee? Why? Because the verb 1 here is drink, not drink. For our learning today about verbal sentence in past tense, the conclusion is there are 3 kinds of sentence here. They are positive, negative, and interrogative. At the first time, you have to look which one will you choose between verb 1 and verb 2. Yang pertama, kalian harus perhatikan pada kalimat verbal past tense di sini, yaitu yang harus kamu pilih antara kata kerja bentuk 1 atau kata kerja bentuk 2. Here, difference with before, di sini berbeda dengan sebelumnya. Kalau nominal verbal, you have to look the subject. Kalau kalimat nominal, sebelumnya kamu harus melihat subject. But verbal here, you have to look the subject anymore. You have just to look which one will you choose between verb 1 and verb 2. Kamu hanya harus memperhatikan kapan menggunakan verb 1, kapan menggunakan verb 1. For positive 1, you have to use verb 2. But negative and interrogative, you have to use verb 1. I think that's all. Jadi, saya kira cukup itu. Jadi, kamu harus memperhatikan kalau kalimat positif itu kata kerjanya bentuk 2. Sedangkan kalimat negatif sama interrogatif itu kata kerjanya kembali ke bentuk 1 karena sudah ada kata did. Okay students, I think that's all for today. Don't forget to see the next scene. See you!